time to transform everything into a mini welder. Ever wonder what you could do with a broken nail clipper? Don't toss it just yet. Hi everyone, welcome to my cozy DIY corner. Today, we're gonna breathe new life into it and turn it into a super handy mini welding tool. With just a few common items like some wire, a plastic tube, and a bit of creativity, you'll have a small but incredibly useful tool. I'll guide you through it step by step. Easy to follow and totally safe. Are you ready to get creative? Let's get started. I already have a broken nail clipper here. Now, connect the broken nail clipper to the wire. We'll use the metal part of the clipper as one of the contact points. Take a piece of insulated wire and strip about 1 to 2 centimeters of the insulation from one end. Then, firmly attach the exposed wire to the metal surface of the nail clipper. You can wrap it around a screw or solder it for a stronger connection. Make sure the connection is tight and secure. You can fit the soldering tip right into this hole. Or you can turn these parts into the soldering tip too. It works just fine. Now I'm going to use this plastic tube as a handle. Simple and effective. Next, I'll grab a piece of plastic tube to use as a handle. This will make it easier and safer to hold while using the mini welder. Just slide the wire and nail clipper assembly into the tube. Make sure it fits snugly. If it's a bit loose, you can wrap some tape around the base or add a bit of glue to hold in place. Comfort and control are important, even for small DIY tools like this. To hold it firmly, I'll use cotton and some super strong glue. Using cotton and super glue not only helps secure the parts firmly in place, but also provides some insulation and cushioning. The cotton acts as a soft barrier that prevents the metal parts from shifting or rubbing against the plastic handle, which can improve the overall durability and safety of your mini welder. I'm going to fix it in place with some cotton and super glue. The cotton helps cushion and hold everything tightly inside the plastic handle. Apply a small amount of super glue around the cotton to keep it from moving. Make sure everything is secure, but be careful not to use too much glue to avoid mess. This way, the handle will feel comfortable and sturdy when you use your mini welder. I'll work on the wiring to connect it to the battery. Take the stripped end of each wire and securely wrap it around the metal part of the battery clamp. If possible, twist the wire tightly or solder to make sure it won't come loose. I need one more wire, with both ends connected to two battery clamps. The battery clamp allows for quick connections, easy installation, and adjustments if needed. This clamp terminal is usually designed with a spring clip or screw tightening mechanism, making it easy to attach and remove without complex tools. These are old batteries. I'll repurpose the graphite rod from old batteries to make the soldering tip. Graphite is a good conductor of electricity and has a high melting point, making it a great choice for this project. Now, let's disassemble the battery to extract the graphite rod inside. Watch the video until the end, and let me know which method you like the most. I'm really looking forward to hearing from you. I'll sharpen one end to improve the welding contact point. Fit the battery core right into the hole on the nail clipper. It should sit snugly. So, the mini welding tool is now ready to go. Now, let's prepare a motorcycle battery. It has a voltage of 12V, which is enough to power this welding machine. Connect the red wire to the positive terminal and the blue wire to the negative terminal. Before welding, I'll preheat the soldering tip. Now, I'll test it with two razor blades. Wow, it works so well. It heats up quickly, creates clean welds, and operates smoothly without any interruptions. A total success. After testing it with razor blades, the results exceeded expectations. Fast and strong welding, a well-deserved success. So there you have it, a simple but powerful mini welder made from everyday items. It's compact, creative, and actually works. Just remember, always be careful when working with electricity and sharp tools. Safety first. What do you guys think? Do you like this idea? Don't forget to leave a comment and share your thoughts. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and see you in the next video. Goodbye.